Let's see the next M statement. Here they are asking us to interpret the relation between risk and reward. Okay. We have seen earlier that higher risk means that you should get higher return, right? But you should consider the variability of the return, right? So what we have is, we have a portion of the variability which you can measure. So measurable portion of the variability, it can be considered as a risk. However, that portion which is not measurable, okay, it can be considered as uncertainty. So what we are saying is that, okay, risk, okay, is what you can measure, okay, and what you cannot measure, you think as uncertain. And then take public traded securities. Okay, what we are saying is that treasury bonds have less credit risk as compared to corporate. As a result, yield of treasury should be less than the corporate across all maturity. Right? However, for a given maturity, okay, for determining the risk and return, we should also consider the liquidity risk. Typically, the treasuries are much more liquid as compared to the corporate bonds. Okay, then tax impact. Okay, so please note that some bonds, like municipal bonds, are risk-free, tax-free, whereas many other bonds are taxable. So you have to see the tax impact and the risk tolerance. Okay, note that if things are same, okay, you will find that, okay, sometimes people are same in terms of, like, say, treasury and the corporate, but sometimes people are willing to take more in interest in corporate bond, or willing to invest in corporate bond as compared to the treasury bond. That will happen when the business environment is very good. Right? So people, what happens is, sometimes people risk tolerance becomes lower, and sometimes people risk tolerance become higher. Right? During the expansion, risk tolerance is higher. So expansion period, risk tolerance is higher. As a result, the yield requirement in the corporate bond is less. So it results in lower spread. So spread will be lower between the corporate and the treasury. Right? It is like, think of as your security market line. Okay, so let's say this is your security market line. Okay, this is your RFR. Right? So think as a slope, this is slope. What happens is, during, we have two periods. Let's say, suppose your beta of the product is 1. Sometimes people want 10% return. Sometimes people want 15% return. Nothing has changed. RFR is same. Okay. Only the degree of risk aversion has changed. So this blue line has higher degree of risk aversion. Okay. And or lower risk tolerance. And this red line has higher risk tolerance. People are willing to take lower return for the same level of risk. So higher risk tolerance means lower spread, lower risk tolerance means higher spread. Right? In case of non-public security, however, the relationship is more complex because you do not rely on the pricing. Okay? Pricing is less reliable. You do not know. In case of public traded, you have large number of buyers and sellers. So the outcome is, you can say, okay, this is the average outcome. So you can say you can rely on the prices. But in case of non-public securities, the pricing can be considered as less reliable. Now, what we see is that some entities or some companies, they have weak risk management culture. So it comes from the top, the senior. Actually, the risk management culture has to be promoted in the firm by the senior management. Okay. So when the companies have weak risk management culture, it results in overestimation of the potential return, right? And the return, because the returns are not adjusted for the risk. If the returns are adjusted for the risk, then the potential return expectation would be lower, right? And also they may ignore some of the risk, as an example, correlation risk. And while computing some of the risk, it can be wrongly computed, or it can be done purposely because they would want to increase the year-end bonus so that they can get more bonus at the end of the year. Also, mark-to-market accounting may result in inflated profits. Think about when in a particular year the returns are very good. Right? Now, in future it may happen that the returns may be bad. Okay, right. So the companies, when they are doing computing the M2M return, okay, they are not adjusting for the risk. Right? Now, these returns are actually just paper profits. Okay, no real cash has been generated, and the companies give out the bonus based on this paper profit. Right? What will happen if there is a loss next year? Right? Will the company get the back the bonus that it has given to the employees? Right? So It is mostly coming because of the weak risk management culture that companies may be suffering losses and the insiders are making money.